hint of what the dawn would bring, everyone secretly wishing that conditions would suit them best. The briefing, headed by trials director Chris McDonald, outlined the rules and regulations of the race and explained how the winner would be decided.
The fastest boat wins the race. There are 17 classes and there are corrected times in each class. So each class boat wins his own class. We have first, second and third outright.
The spectacular sunrise over the undisturbed Clarence revealed almost perfect conditions. As the sun slowly rose to take up its position, already ski race participants were making their way to the boat ramp, putting the final touches to their already spotless machines. First 74 boats drawn to start were required to line up on the bank outside the Crown Hotel. While the first boats were awaiting their countdown, the other 133 entrants were gathering on the opposite bank off Susan Island. The banks of the river were a hype of activity, with skiers strapping ankles, checking ropes and skis, and drivers preparing for the lightning trip down to Harwood and back. With only minutes to go before the first boats were waved away, hundreds of spectators were jostling for the best possible vantage points. The unlimited entries of Agro Status and Team Bullet had drawn the number one and two positions. The starter gave the signal. The countdown began. And for more than 1,000 skiing enthusiasts, the moment of truth had arrived. Waved away from the starting line at 2 minute intervals. Once the drivers received their 5 second countdown, it was full speed ahead. Broughton and Moonlight Creeper wasted no time in letting their rivals know they meant business. Keeping pace with Tom Hughes's Top Gun, Broughton was biding his time. Deep inside, the pressure's high, just to stay alive. Cause the heat is on. Woo! Oh, 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 caught up in the action. Leaving the start at 19th position didn't deter Harris and the Super Fortress crew. They had the number one ski boat. They were out for the number one prize. The heat is on. The heat is on. The heat is on. It wasn't long before Harris was challenging the earlier starters, with Cropper and Brown signalling to observer Charlie Stock with the traditional thumbs up. Harris pushed the pedal to the metal. The race was on. The $90,000 19-footer with the blown 454 inboard hull took full advantage of the Clarence River's wide straits. Harris was calling on every bit of the inboard's 900 horsepower, and it responded beautifully. With less than half the race completed, the tough course was already taking its toll. One of the earliest casualties was the fancied network, if only the boat performed as well as it looked. For Stan Nager, observer Steve Donnelly, and skiers Murray and Rory Brown, the race was over. Like its namesake, Lester Fremantle's Assassin had also been stopped, dead in its tracks, succumbing to the Clarence's reputation as the toughest ski race circuit in the country. The skiers too were feeling the pinch. As the boats began the homeward leg along Woodford Island, skiers were calling on all their reserve tanks and on friends for reassurance. For some, the words of encouragement, the enlightening news that it would soon all be over, just wasn't enough. There was only so much a man could endure. Only 43 minutes and 31 seconds after they were waved away, Graham Webb's rock solid screamed past the black and white checkered finishing buoy to take out line honours. Once back on shore, skier Ken Hoy described the run.
We probably got over 90 mile an hour, somewhere just over there. It was very good conditions. We tried to pace ourselves. It's the first time we've run together, so we were just basically getting the team organised and using this run for the bridge to bridge, and it looks like we've done pretty good.
But Chris North wasn't confident that their time, more than 2 minutes outside the race record, would be enough to be awarded victory.
Oh, maybe a third, around a third, second overall.
Not long after Rock Solid passed the line, the other challengers followed suit, some in more impressive style than others. Hotly pursued by an NRTV cameraman, Graham Harris looked a blur of speed as he rounded the home turn for the final leg. The Super Fortress team could smell victory. Their time recorded was 43 minutes flat. They were going to be hard to beat, and they knew it.
We're both very tired.
But for skiers Danny Cropper and Craig Brown, it had been a tough run.
So I did 3/4 of the race over the plane barrier. It's very hard to do.
What did you do to try and combat that?
Cry. Cry and yell a lot. Abuse drivers and observers.
But it had been all worth the pain.
Everything that we've done is worthwhile. It's been a good race.
The official placings had yet to be posted. There were still many out on the water. Greg Campbell put on the speed, chasing the women's class record. Tanya Williams and Eva Ryan had no objections. They crossed the line in an incredible 49 minutes and 51 seconds. Campbell was impressed.
They've done a really good job. I'm very proud of them.
While many of the competitors lined up awaiting their exit from the course, they took time out to congratulate themselves on finishing the race. But Graham Harris had come to win, and win he did. Super Fortress was awarded the 1988 Grafton Bridge to Bridge, and it was just the start.
We won the series last year, which the bridge is a part of. But we didn't win any major races. We always got second. We're always the bridesmaid. We got second and thirds and what have you. And this year would be great. You know, we'd like to win Grafton Bridge to Bridge, Sydney Bridge to Bridge, and Lion Island. So we've got number one out of the way, haven't we?
Harris was quick to add that it was a team effort that had won him first prize.
You need a special crew, I think. You need two good skiers. You need a boat that's capable of the speed. And the boat's definitely capable of the speed. And the skiers have proved that they're up to it today. You know, they're two good skiers and the team's come together. You need a little bit of luck. You need a lot of luck.
He had the luck, he had the boat, the crew, and of course the skiers. But as far as Harris was concerned, Danny Cropper and Craig Brown could have it all to themselves. He wouldn't change places.
Not for quids, no. I wouldn't get on the back. No, it's silly. I think they're mad.
Mad they might be, but they're winners. And winners can laugh and smile as they taste the sweetness of success.